On a cold autumn evening, diving into the bins of my curious brain, I came across an interesting thought. What would happen if all the geographical borders disappear from the world map? But before we begin, make sure and hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell for more amazing videos. That being said, let's begin. Formation of countries. Throughout the history of society, many different countries were founded and dissolved. Small groups of people joined other small groups, thus gradually creating a society. The society grew and eventually needed a certain order. The most respected and even the strongest people provided it, and so the power began to emerge. A country is traditionally defined as a collection of sovereign states with their own territory, population, and government. Among the oldest countries in the world are Egypt, first settled around 6000 BC. And China, whose civilization dates back nearly 4,000 years ago. Japan celebrates 660 BCE as the first year of its founding. On the European continent, France and Austria are among the oldest countries, dating back to CE 843 and 976, respectively. The Republic of San Marino is a tiny landlocked country in Italy, which was founded on September 3rd in the year 301 BCE. Its constitution, established in 1600, is the oldest in the world. Countries continue to be formed today. In the past generation, there have been 34 new countries created. About half of these came into existence after the dissolution of the Soviet Union. At first, there were no borders since there was a lot of populated territory. However, not all of it was suitable for sustainable living. Therefore, certain communities began to protect their land from strangers. They didn't want outsiders to claim resources which they felt belonged to them. In this way, the first borders and the first countries were created. Certain people were in, while others were out. Once the good lands ran out and the countries grew, conflicts and often wars ensued. The have-nots attacked the haves. And sometimes the already haves attacked other haves just so they could have more. The conquering country took away the lands of the defeated country, thereby overtaking it. Even in recent history, countries have been formed and dissipated. Look at Czechoslovakia, Yugoslavia, and the USSR. These are the countries that existed only a generation ago. Yet, due to internal political conflicts, they disappeared in a matter of moments. No more borders. In light of such vulnerability, the question arises, what if something were to happen to your country, to my country, to all countries, where they cease to exist? Moreover, what if the geographic borders of world states were to disappear? What if we were to imagine, as John Lennon so sweetly implored us to, that there were no countries? What would happen then? All the government workers would have to immediately find new jobs. There would be no state or government to fund their salaries. Prices for goods would drop noticeably due to the absence of taxes. That would be a welcome change at first, until people begin to realize that they might have to personally set aside funds for policemen, firemen, doctors, teachers, and all other public occupations. People responsible for health and education care would need to find an alternate way to make a living, either through private funds or even a career change. And until there is a stable justice system, gangs would likely begin to form in the streets. The land might return to vigilante justice if the area's crime rate sharply increased due to lack of city, state, and national enforcement officers. Common bonds. A responsible society could quickly be divided into small sections and people based on class or race or religion. The physical boundaries holding people together would be gone, and so people would naturally look for other common bonds by which to identify themselves. They would find ways to separate into us and them. Such a broken society cannot get along adequately together, thus making collective work impossible. Plants and factories would quit production and would lead to a shortage of many basic goods. Trade between cities would cease due to lack of workers and raw materials. People would begin to empty store shelves as there wouldn't be any new goods arriving for a long time. Civilization breakdown. Ultimately, all kinds of power plants would stop their work. Subsequently, people would lose gas and water in their houses. And even if someone would want to escape that misery, they would be unlikely to find a working gas station. All sources of public transportation, airports, auto and railway stations, and even taxi services would have to cease operating. The absence of such familiar benefits of humanity would cause human civilization to deteriorate to third world conditions. Mass migrations. And what would happen to people who were already living in third world conditions? When they hear that there are no longer any borders keeping them in, they will most likely seek to move out to areas with better living. The residents of North and Central Africa would immigrate to Europe and the Arabian Peninsula. People on the South American continent would journey northward to North America, and the citizens of Eastern and Southeast Asia will head to the area of China. Such people might travel for weeks and months toward an area they perceive as the Promised Land. However, coming to them, they would only be greeted by disappointment. Their aspired new home would no longer exist. The industrial system of once great countries will have disappeared, and assimilating into the new society would be even tougher. Because now the problem with accepting migrants into a certain territory would not be that they would take jobs from the original citizens or that they would likely sow discord on political or religious grounds. Rather, the problem would be simply that outsiders would seek to claim the few remaining resources that are so important for life. Food, water, powering energy. In summary, the problems in the Promised Land would be the same as those the migrants had hoped to leave behind. Isolation. Just as in pre-civilized societies, there would be massive conflicts. As it was thousands of years ago, the struggle would begin for a place in the sun. Might would make right. In militaristic countries, remaining stockpiles of weapons would be looted by outlaws and vigilantes seeking to secure their own interests. Modern means of communication would be absent. Contact with territories of former countries would not be possible either. This means no external police and economic relations. Domestic politics would be built on constant wars for resources. As is evident, the instant dissolution of the states and their borders would likely lead to a deplorable ending. Gradual dissolution. Would the situation be better, though, if you were to break down the border gradually with planned preparations? There are currently 203 recognized and partially recognized states. They differ in territory and population, but most importantly in their standard of living. Due to historical situations, not all countries are located on profitable lands. Also, due to some geographical accidents and modern society needs, some countries are in a particularly good situation. For example, look at the status of countries where oil has been found. But such a historic and geographical randomization cannot divide the country with its inhabitants into rich and poor. We are people of the 21st century. Daily, we discover new medicine, construction, and technologies that allow us to improve our modern living. Would it ever be possible to make an organic change in society? Could the most powerful people on the planet gather to discuss uniting countries into one world union? Would such a change indeed put an end to poverty and wars and other political conflicts? Could we imagine a world in which every person would have the same rights to natural resources as each of their neighbors? Could we imagine a world where peoples were not separated by race, religion, or even language? Could we imagine a world where everything works for the benefit of society and the planet as a whole? Paradise. Some people would say that such a possibility could happen only in paradise. Yet, what can we do in our own communities today to ensure more positive societal relationships for future generations? While we remain descendants of fallen humanity, we should understand that no matter what country we live in, we are responsible for each person on our planet. The future of mankind depends on our present actions. By regularly reaching out to our neighbor, we can gradually improve the life of every citizen on the earth. Although it is not necessary for the borders of the countries to disappear to make that happen, it's just conventions. First of all, you need to remove the boundaries inside you. That's it for this release. Please write in the comments section what you think would happen if there were only one world.